Welcome to everyone. In this class, we are going to discuss about women in the freedom movement. So, women also participated freedom in our country because 1600 British East India Company came to India the purpose of trade. But later, Battle of Plassey 1757, they became their more political power in India. In the Battle of Plassey, British East India Company and Siraj ud Dowlah, the Nawab of Bengal, the fought against, they became their more political power in India after the Battle of Plassey 1757. So, in this freedom movement, women also participated, get the freedom our country. So, like Velu Nachiyar, so one of the Tamil freedom struggler, Velu Nachiyar, then Jhansi Rani, next one, Begum Hasrat Mughal, they all one of the important freedom fighter against British East India Company. So, they mention one of the important revolters, Vellore Mutiny and Great Revolt of 1857. So, this Vellore Mutiny, it was happened in our Tamil Nadu. So, this is prelude for the Great Revolt of 1857. So, up to 1857, British East India Company ruled in our country. So, later 1857, British government directly ruled in our country. Okay. So, like many freedom strugglers participated freedom in our country. So, one of the important freedom strugglers is Velu Nachiyar. She was Queen of Sivagangai. When she was 14 years old, she married Muthu Vadudanathar. Okay. So, Raja of Sivagangai. After the Kalayar Koyil battle, British East India Company killed Muthu Vadudanathar. So, Velu Nachiyar and his daughter Vellachi Nachiyar escaped and moved to the Tindukal. In that place, with help of Marudu brothers, with help of grateful follower Kuyili, again they recaptured the Sivagangai. Okay, so she is the first woman against the British East India Company. Okay, so Velu Nachiyar. Velu Nachiyar is the first woman against the British East India Company. So, she called as Tamil Veeramangai. Okay, Veeramangai or South India of Jhansi Rani. So, she is the first woman against British East India Company. And they given them many importance to struggle for their freedom. So, they boycotted the British goods. Okay. They not allowed to wear the British goods. So, they boycotted the British goods, colleges, schools. So, everything they boycotted the British and they used only the Indian product. Okay. They used only the Indian product. So, this freedom movement, so they taken this all the steps to avoid the British goods. Okay. So, this called as boycotted. Boycotted means avoid. So, avoid the British goods during the freedom movement. And next one is impact of reform movement. Impact of reform movement. So, in this lesson, the final topic is what is impact? So, reform movement not only for women. So, the men also. So, many men, they struggle against the British East India Company. Okay. So, like many person, Rajaram Mohan Roy, Kandukuri Veerasalingam, M.G. Ranade and B.M. Malabari, Govala Krishna Govale, Periyar E.V.R. So, like many men reformer and women reformer, they participated against the British East India Company. So, what is the final impact of this reform movement? So, they taken this reform movement. Sari was abolished with the help of British East India Company, the governor of William Bentinck. Okay. So, 1829, they abolished the Sari. And next one is, they abolished the Devadasi system. So, what is Devadasi system? The female, they have to work to the God, serve to the God. They should not marry the other person. It's called as Devadasi system. So, this also abolished with help of this reform. And widow remarriage. So, sadhi means husband and wife also want to die. It is called as sadhi. But Later, the abolished 1829, but they not allowed to the second marriage. Okay. So, with the help of this reform, they abolished the, and they getting the permission of widow remarriage. Okay, widow remarriage. And next, they given the importance of the national awakening. All the national should be united. So, national awakening. And they giving the feeling of sacrifice. So, all the freedom reformer, they work with sacrifice, service and rationalism. And the abolish the infanticide, infanticide. So, with the help of this everything, the abolish the help of reform movement. Abolish the sadhi, then abolish the devadasi system, infanticide, forticide. So, this are impact of reform movement. Okay. And as soon as law. So, what are the law passed during the British East India Company? So, the first one is Bengal Regulation Act 1804. Bengal Regulation Act 1804, female infanticide is considered as a crime, female infanticide. So, what is female infanticide? After born, female born, they are killed. Okay, so it is called as female infanticide. So, the help of Bengal Act 1804, it was abolished. Then, 1829, they abolished the sadhi. Okay, so sadhi means husband, die means wife also want to die in that funeral pyre, so it is called as sadhi. So 1829, with the help of Lord William Bentinck, he is the Governor General of British East India Company. The social reformer is Raja Ram Mohan Roy. The abolished is the sadhi, 1829 sadhi. Okay. And next one is Hindu Widow Remarriage Act 1856. After husband die, wife also can marriage another person. So it is permitted the widow remarriage. So permitted the widow remarriage from 1856. Okay. And next one is 1872, child marriage was prohibited. So, in that period, the woman marriage age is 10. Okay. So, below 10, they married. So, it was prohibited in 1872. They fixed for woman 14 and men 16. The marriage age of woman 14 and for men 16, this 1872. After they given the amendment for woman 18 and men 21. Okay. So before they fixed for women 14 and men for 16. So later the amendment correction for women 18 and men 21. So at present they are going to increase. Very soon they are going to increase for women 21. Still it is not came to effect. But very soon they are going to increase for women the marriage age is 21. If you married before the 18, it was considered as crime. Okay, if they married for women before 18 and men before 21, it is considered as a crime. So, 1872, they prohibited the child marriage. Then, saw the Act 1930, the age of marriage was fixed. Okay, so the 1830, they fixed the marriage age for women 14 and for men 16. So later the amendment for women 18 and men for 21. Okay, so the Marriage Act 1830. As soon as Devadasi Abolition Act 1947. So Devadasi system. So what is Devadasi system? So after born female child served to the god. Okay, served to the god, they can learn the Bharatanatyam, everything, but they should not marry. So it is Devadasi system. So it was abolished 1947. So it was abolished 1947. Later, after that, it was considered as a crime. If anyone forced to serve to the god means, it was considered as a crime. And they given the permission, Devadasi can marry the person. So they given the permission after this act 1947. Okay. So second lesson is completed. Status of women in India through the ages. So different period: ancient period, medieval period, middle period, and modern period. So this different period, how they can treated the women, we discussed in this lesson. So many social evils faced in our society. So like sadhi, female infanticide, female forticide, devadasi system. So like many things social evils faced in our country, it was abolished with the help of social reformer. Okay, so with the help of social reformer, they abolished against social, women social evils. At present, the women are participated in all the department like engineer, doctor, teacher. So like they are working all the field. At present, we gave to the women full freedom. Okay, full freedom. So this lesson, how they treated the different ages in our country, we have discussed. So next class, we'll discuss third lesson. Okay. Next your question session. Learn and write the following. Your question is, discuss women in the freedom movement. Next question is, explain impact of reform movement. So understand the topic, read word, then write your classwork note. Thank you. Have a nice day.